dance in life's dance. You be the partner I hold. You and me, together growing old. When you're mourning, I'll mourn for your sadness and pain. When you're happy, you'll put a smile on my face. I won't be perfect, but I promise I'll try every day for you. And I will be, yeah, I will be, I will be whatever you need me to be. Joke if it means we both laugh. The unaware bunny-eared man in the photograph. I'd give the whole of my heart if it means you get half. Darling, please be my better half. And I will be, yeah. Thank you.
Thank you. በስመ አብ ወወልድ ወመንፈስ ቅዱስ አሐዱ አምላክ አሜን። አቤቱ አምላካችን መድኃኒታችን ኢየሱስ ክርስቶስ የአባታችን የአብርሃምን የሳራን የርብቃን የራሄልን ማዕድ የባረክ ጋብቻ የባረክ የቀደስ ዛሬ ዕለት ጋብቻቸውን የሚፈጽሙ የልጆቻችን ሕይወት እንድትባረክ እንድትቀድስ በመካከላቸው ተገኝተ መላ ዘመናቸው ባረከህ ቀድሰ በጤንነት በሰላም በክብር ዘመናቸውን አርዝመ ከነሱ ጋር እንድትሆን ቸሩ እግዚአብሔር በቸርነት እንምናለን።
አሜን።
በየጊዜው በየሰዓት ሁሉ በቸርነት ተጠብቀን
አሜን።
ማዳችንን ይባርክልን ይቀድስልን
አሜን።
ከእናታችን ከቅድስት ድንግል ማርያም በረከተ ረድኤት ክብር ይክፈለን። በሰላም ለዚህ ሰዓት ለዚህ ዕለት ስላደረስከን እናመሰግናለን እናመልካለን። አሁንም የተረፈው ሰዓት ባረከ ቀድሰ በሰላም እንድታሳድረን እንደምናሃለን። እግዚአብሔር አምላካችን በሕይወታቸው በሰራቸው በኑሯቸው ይግባ የተባረከ የተቀደሰ ዘር ይስጣቸው። አሁን ዘበሰማያት ከመበሰማያት ከማሁበም ድረስ ሳይን ዘለን ለዕለትና ሀበናዮም ድግዚያ ሳኖ ጋያን ከምር ጠላአነ እግዚኦ ውስተ መንሱ ታላልነን አዋልአነ ግንዚያ ከይት መንግስት አይደሷት ለዓለም ዓለም ሰላም ቅዱስ ገብርኤል መልአኩ ወይቴ ማርያም ሰላም ነች እንግል በልናቸው እንግል በስጋችን እንዲያህል ሰው ሰላም ታንቲ ማርሱ ተፈሲ ፍሴት ኦምል ተጸጋ እግዚአብሔር ስለች ሳለ ጸነ መልአ ቆሮበት ኢየሱስ ክርስቶስ በእስራኤልና ሀጣ ወይነ ተማጸነች ኦ እግዚአብሔር ወአምላኬ ኢየሱስ ክርስቶስ ስራይ ኃጢአቴ ወኃጢአተ ኩሉ ህዝብከ ማይሰራ ኃጢአት እግዚአብሔር ይፍታ። እግዚአብሔር ይባርካችሁ እግዚአብሔር ይቀድሳችሁ።
Semret, my love, my friend,
My Habesha queen. I'm so honored to share this beautiful and blessed day with you and Baba. One of the things I always remember about our friendship, I reflect back on our walks that we took on the beach, on the boardwalk, every Sunday.
Yes.
We would walk after 5 o'clock p.m. It's when the sun goes down, so we don't get burned. So we would always walk on the beach, and that was our time to reflect on our past and the time that we took to project on our future. So we would walk about 3 to 5 miles, we would walk, and we would just talk about our past and talk about what we wanted our future to be. And we would talk about, Sim would always put love and family first. I would always put money and career first. And she would always tell me, you have to put love and family first, and the career and money can wait. It will come to you when you're worthy of it. And I would
thanks, Kendall.
Yeah. I always remember, she always reminded me to focus on my vision. Focus on the law of attraction. You bring your future into your life. If you focus on it and you believe in it, it will happen. If you don't put any work in on it and you don't believe in it, it's not gonna happen. She would tell me this every Sunday. Every Sunday. So she always reminded me to work on my vision board. And now we're here and I'm watching all your dreams and all your visions come true.
Aww.
I love you. You represent hope and dreams for me, because everything you hoped for and you dreamt for is coming true. It's all here. I'm so happy for you. I love you, and I can't imagine life without you. You are my my sister. Half day.
Half day.
Half day. Yes.
Yes, I love you.
Thank you. Would you pass the microphone to Angela?
Hello, everybody. Thank you. First of all, congratulations to Semret and Rob. Can you guys hear me?
Yeah.
I'm so honored to be part of this beautiful story. I feel that God brought you together in this time, and just absolutely perfect. Obviously, we know that Sem is gorgeous. Oh. Everywhere we go, people stop and they just stare at her. They look at her everywhere we go.
Yeah.
But all you have to do is spend 5 minutes with her, and you know that that inner beauty and that childlike enthusiasm is over everything. It just, it was amazing. This amazing woman has gone over obstacles that none of us even know. And 2 years ago, she was diagnosed with a rare disease, and we thought that most people would never recover from it. But if you know Sam, you know she fought hard. And only a few months after that diagnosis, enters Robert. He met her at her most vulnerable and her weakest, and he brought light when she really needed it the most. God knew that this is what she needed. Well, in Sem-like fashion, she went through painful physical therapy, hard workouts. People here know how hard she worked. And she had only 2 dreams when I met her. She wanted to become an IFBB, an International Federation Bodybuilding Pro.
Yeah.
And she wanted to find a loving, kind man. And she was very clear that it had to be quality. Of course, in a year, she accomplished both.
Yes.
She got her pro card, which is very hard to do. And she met the love of her life. So anything is possible with this beautiful woman. And I just cannot imagine what their future is going to be like with this beautiful baby. Congratulations, and we wish you tenderness, love.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Gina, are you available?
Available.
Available.
Say a few words. Rob, can you believe I forgot that I was supposed to speak tonight?
No, so yes, I can. I am.
So, Rob, I can't speak. I'm going to stop already. I can't even say a few words. Rob has been with Benissimo. I'm the cheese lady. And Rob bicycled up more than 10 years ago to the shop, saw that there was an ad. We were looking for a cheesemonger. Came into the shop and applied more than 10 years ago. And he's been with us that long. He is the most mature,
tenured,
eldest, oldest cheesemonger that we have. And all I can say, Rob and Sam, I'm so happy for you both. Honestly.
So
happy
you.
I can't talk. But if I can say, and if you don't get offended, Sam.
No.
I lay of lay uye. Because I asked Rob if he could speak another language. He said he could speak Latin.
Good job,
I you guys. And I'm so happy for you. And all the best. I just wish you nothing but.
Thank you, Gina.
And now, all the way from San Jose.
No.
Wait.
Cedar Rapids. Excuse me. This is in Iowa. This is Uncle Jim, lovingly known as Apple.
Apple.
Boy, how do you follow this?
Hold your mouth.
I am Rob, and now Sam's official Uncle Apple.
Yes.
And it's urban legend that has it. I think that Dan started this about 40 years ago. Had a hard time saying Uncle, so it came out Apple, and it's been Apple ever since then. Is that true?
That's true.
And there's been some derivation from there, and Rob's had a lot of them, from Appinator, AppDog, Appster,
AppMeister,
Apple, Appen, all of them. And I still answered all those up at the bar, so. There's been three wedding invitations in the California area here, so. We'll go back a little bit in memory lane. I hope you don't mind there. First one was in 1972, 47 years ago. I was best man at my brother Gary's. And his lovely wife, Linda, and I gave the best man speech there, and froze for about 30 seconds. I called it a dramatic pause, but there's some dispute about those. I froze. So we're making up for it today, but that was a great day too. And then 2 years later, I also married Linda Graff, so got a little confusing around the telephone there, but that was 1974.
And
sad to say, both of those Lindas succumbed to cancer, and anything we wish they could be here today, but they live on. So, in the second one was in the date was September 15th. I was supposed to come out September 13th, and the year was 2001. And the planes were grounded in Cedar Rapids. Of course, that was 9/11 there. So I've been waiting 18 years to toast Dan and Courtney, so let's do it now. And now, moving on to the third couple here. So we've been traveling, Rob, Roe, and myself, and Tim went the first year there, but we kind of got some catchphrases and things we said there, but a lot of inside jokes and a lot of stuff. So, but a couple of them were good man, and that would be anything from usually that was when I picked up the tab for one of Rob's meals. But, good man for anything he did, but you were a good man. And the other one was good stuff. That could be anything from Dan's music today to a great feast here, our time in Austria last year with Tina and Roger, all that good stuff. So, so you're a good man, Rob. You're a good man, Stan.
Good man.
And this ceremony and this day has been good stuff. So
thank you, Apple.
One last one.
Oh, we're not done.
No.
I always, guys, always thought we text back and forth every day, and we let's try. I got the right. And we text back and forth. We like lyrics and song stuff and everything. So I'm gonna pick one from my man Neil Young, and it's a great song. It's called "Long May You Run," and it was. I wrote it about 50 years ago, but it's a kind of a metaphor for life, good life, long life, happy life, fulfilling life. And I'll just go with the verse here. We'll put the glasses on. So I changed the words a little bit here. You go through some things together with trunks of memories still to come. You'll find things to do in stormy weather. Long may you run.
Ladies and gentlemen, I give you Mr. Gary Graff, Rob Staff.
His face was covered with chocolate, his shirt with chocolate, his pants with chocolate, and chocolate on the floor. There was a chocolate spoon in the sink. And she said to him, Rob, is there any chance that you got on a stool and took some ice cream out of the freezer? Rob said, No, what do you mean? And a little later than that, his mother took him shopping down to a drugstore, and that's the thing. They came back, and she saw him playing on the floor with a little toy truck. And she said to him, Rob, I haven't seen that before. Where'd that come from? He said, oh, a friend gave it to me. And his mother said, you know, it's a sin to tell a lie. I'm going to tell your father about this. No reaction. And then she said, I'm going to tell a parish priest about it. She didn't say a word. Then she said, I'm going to tell God about it. Still didn't matter. And then she said, I'm going to tell Santa Claus about it. And the kid broke up and fell over the floor, and they went back to the drugstore with an apology. Anyways, those are just a couple of short stories. Anyway, so they wandered up and down meet and went to grade school and high school. And after high school, he came down here to San Diego to go to school, San Diego State. And after that, as Gina said, by chance, he met her, and she's given me that story, and she hired him as the Patrice Monger. That's the legendary Gina Freese from the Nisimo Empire down here now. Anyway, so that's how that cheese history got started. And really, when you think about it, if you've gone to San Diego State and have a major in political science, what else can you do but sell cheese? So about a year and a half ago, I got a text from Rob. He said, I'm moving into a new apartment. I have a girlfriend. And the text said, her name was Semret. He spelled it for me. And he said she's from Eritrea. Is that a city up in in northern New York, and so I googled it. I found out what a great little place that was. How to pronounce it, and found out a lot more about you. And he said four words in the text. You're really gonna like Sam. Those four words. And a month later, I came down to visit Rob and meet Sam for a soccer tournament, and the family did too. And he was right. We all just fell in love with Sam, and the rest is kind of history there. And, you know, everybody knows your life story, that you came here from a war-torn country in northern Africa. Didn't speak a word of English. You were in your mid-teens, I think, right?
Yeah.
And you were lucky to wind up with some wonderful foster parents,
yes.
Stephen and Betty Ball. And Betty actually walked you down the aisle today, so honors to you guys, too, for such a wonderful job of raising her here. Nurturing and loving home, so thank you. I was going to say something too about Sam's problem with the
What's up, buddy?
With the problem you had with the disease, that's right, in public. You've been a remarkable recovery.
Thank you.
In fact, when I came down to meet you guys, you still had a cane, I think.
Yeah.
And
yes.
I thought, geez, this is incredible. And I will say, I think Rob and Sam are just a perfect match. I think we'd all agree to that. But, I mean, really, they have so much in common. They're focused, they're independent, they're grounded, they're well organized. They both like to travel. They may not travel so much for the next couple of years, but they love to travel. They both have a great sense of humor, which I think is a huge asset for a new husband and wife, especially. So I think the only regret I have is that you say these things, is that, and Rob covered this this morning, is that his mom can't be here.
Yeah.
And also, Sam's mom can't be here, but I think if your mom was here, and I think anybody that knows her from Alameda knows that she would stand up and go, and so Sam, welcome to the family.
Thank you.
And I look forward to so many more years with you two. Well, you three now really,
yeah.
So all the best. I love all two and all three of you. So
thanks, Dad.
Thank you.
But my name is Dan. I am I'm Rob's oldest brother, which would also, I think, technically make me his oldest friend. I promised, like I said, Rob and Sam, and more importantly, my wife Courtney, to keep things short. So I'm going to attempt to do just that. And Courtney's got the gong. If I run too long, she's not afraid to use it. I could stand up here and I could tell all of you the good and funny stuff about Rob. But that would literally take me hours. And so I could also stand up here and tell you about all the dumb shit that he's done, but that would take me days. Courtney and I got married just over 18 years ago. I think like my dad mentioned or my uncle mentioned. And at our festivities, we invited some close family and friends to come and give a toast or say some words during our rehearsal dinner. That day, Rob had been drinking heavily. And depending on how you view things, Rob was either really, really good at drinking, or he was really, really bad at drinking. We passed him the mic, and he stood up, and he said his name, he introduced himself, his voice cracked, he burst into tears, and sat back down and passed the mic to the next person. So I figure at this point, I've already surpassed all expectations. The reality, though, is that despite the distance between us, Rob and Sam live down here in San Diego, and my wife, Courtney, and I, and our three kids live up in San Jose, he is my closest friend. And when things are going on in our lives, you know, typically the first calls that we make are to each other, and I'm really, really proud of that. I've seen you go through some very high highs in your life, and I've seen you go through very low lows. And you've worked incredibly hard to become the person that you are today, standing before everyone. And to be able to chase your dreams and to pursue your passions. And for me, as your brother and as your friend, it's admirable. And it's really fun to watch you succeed. And Sam, you look beautiful.
Thank
you. Courtney said it best after the first time that we met you. She simply said, she's lovely. Aww. And you are. We feel lucky to welcome you to our family, to be the sister I've never had, the auntie to our kids who love calling me Auntie Sam, and we can't wait to watch you be a mom.
Thank you.
Speaking of which, I hope I'm not ruining anything by mentioning that you're pregnant.
Just happened today.
Sorry. Back in May of this year, we were down here in San Diego for a soccer tournament for my 12-year-old. And Rob and Sam surprised us with a trip to their new house. We were really excited, and by telling us that Sam was pregnant. I really like how you guys have tried to keep the stress level low this year. Well done. Anyhow, after giving us the good news, Rob was showing us around the new house. And he introduced Courtney and I to a new phrase that has become part of our everyday vernacular. Use it all the time. Courtney said something to the effect of, babies are wonderful, but they sure do change your life. And Rob answered with, maybe for most, but my life won't change at all. I'll still be crushing it. So now, on the 25 to 30 times a day that Courtney and I have some type of kid issue, right? Everyone's hungry, but we haven't been to the grocery store. We look at each other, crushed it. Kid gets mad. The kid gets mad at us for, you know, God knows what, and stomps down the hallway, slams his bedroom door. Crush that one. So I'd like to personally thank Rob for introducing that phrase into our lives. We use it all the time. The truth is, though, that crushing it isn't just about being a great brother. You've got that nailed. And it's not about being a great son or a great nephew, because check and check. And crushing it isn't about being a great friend and giving tough love when needed. Crushing it isn't about marrying the woman of your dreams in a new house with a daughter on the way. But I have to admit, we've done good there. Crushing it isn't about chasing your passions and excelling and creating super cool work experiences around cheese. We've done that. Crushing life is about the fact that very few people can pull off a pencil-thin beard and a man bun. There's no further proof, my friend, that you have crushed life. Well done. Well done. So, if everyone will raise a glass to Rob and Sam, whatever you're drinking. Rob and Sam, I hope that today is the best day of your life. And I hope that every tomorrow is even better. Love you guys.
Cheers.
Yeah.
soon as they send it, everything is from the office. They need it to send it. Have you been to Shabbos Street?
Yeah.
It's fucking gorgeous. Gorgeous. Just getting in and out of it, you know.
Yeah, I know. was like, okay, well, the hand is not working out, but now your other hand's getting numb. That's like, it's not the same problem. So I talked to her the other day, he was scared to shit, he was in the end of the day, and I'm like, all day long. He's gonna get MRI, like, 5 o'clock.
Why is he not here?
It's a super slow eater. But yeah, without working out, eating, but I'm like, you know, protein, protein thing. Like, I don't know. And that, like, I'm losing now he's losing control. That was today's news.
Thank you. whatever you need. Okay.
Okay, folks. Mr. DJ. I don't know what I'm saying. I'm not having no.